Good morning, I am Elliot Watier and I am associate professor at the Institut Pasteur in France, in Paris. And I work as a group leader in Dr. Hilde de Roeze's unit on Helicobacter pathogenesis in the Department of Microbiology. Today I am very pleased to talk about our paper published last December in GERD and entitled USF1 defect drive P53 degradation during H. pylori infection and accelerates gastric carcinogenesis. And I would like to thank Professor Eloma, the editor of GERD, to give us this great opportunity. This study was done in collaboration with a group in France, with Professor Marie-Dominique Galibert at the University of Rennes. In this study, we also collaborate with Professor Javier Torres at the Instituto Medico de Seguridad Social in Mexico City, and in Italy with Professor Mario Milcodelios at the University of Florence. In our team, we are interested in the mechanism at the origin of cancer development during bacterial infection. And we study our favorite model, which is Helicobacter pylori, and its relationship with gastric cancer development. Helicobacter pylori is responsible for the most common infection among the world population. This bacterium induces a chronic gastritis in the human stomach that can evolve to gastric cancer for 3% of the infected people. Importantly, up to now, Helicobacter pylori is the only bacterium recognized as a group 1 carcinogenic agent and is a major risk factor for gastric cancer. Gastric cancer is the fifth most common cancer among the world population and it still remains the third leading cause of cancer-related deaths. In previous studies, our team and other groups demonstrated the ability of Helicobacter pylori infection to induce DNA damage and mutation in gastric epithelial cells. And a few years ago, we demonstrated that H. pylori inhibits the expression of the upstream stimulatory factors, USF1. To investigate the consequences of the deregulation of USF1 on the genotoxic host response to H. pylori and gastric carcinogenesis process, we initiate a collaboration with Marie-Dominique Galibert's laboratory, putting all together our expertise in the field of H. pylori infection for our team and on the study of cancer and the mechanism of action of USF1 for her group.
Good morning, my name is Marie-Dominique Galibert. I am professor at the medical school at the University of Rennes and my research group is in the Institute of Genetics and Development. The topic of our group is to understand the underpinning molecular mechanisms that drive cancer development. And we have made in the last year major contribution in the field of melanoma. In addition, we have focused our understanding on the role of the transcription factor USF1, the topic of today's.
USF1 is a pleiotropic transcription factor that regulates many genes and many pathways, including the immune response, the cell proliferation, and DNA repair. And indeed, we have made some major contribution to understanding how USF1 regulates genes of the nucleated excision repair pathway. In addition, we could show a new function of USF1, demonstrating that USF1 is going to be important for the stabilization of P53, a major tumor suppressor. And this has major implication if we think of the gastric cancer, where there is both a loss of USF1 and a loss of P53.
It has been previously demonstrated by Richard Peake's group in the US that H. pylori promotes the proteasomal degradation of P53 through the bacterial oncogenic protein Kage. Based on this data and using complementary in vivo and in vitro approaches in human mice, especially knockout for USF1 and gastric epithelial cell lines, we investigated how the deregulation of the transcription factor USF1 during H. pylori infection could impact the P53 response and promote genetic instabilities and gastric carcinogenesis.
The first step of this study was to fully establish a link between USF1 and gastric cancer using public data from the Genome Cancer Atlas. As you can see, I was able to correlate the level of USF1 and P53 with a worse prognosis. Furthermore, we found that the survival of patients with gastric cancer was significantly reduced when the expression of USF1 and P53 are low.
The second pillar of this study was to establish in vivo that the loss of USF1 was a major event in the development of gastric cancer induced by H. pylori. To do so, we have used USF1 knockout mice, and we have infected wild-type and knockout mice with H. pylori, and we have examined over 12 months, the development of gastric cancer. And we could show at 9 months, there was a very strong difference between normal and a wild-type and USF knockout mice, and we could show they were major dysplasia. This would tell that indeed the loss of USF1 is really a key factor event that is going to promote the development of gastric cancer induced by H. pylori.
Since USF1 and P53 cooperate to maintain genetic stability, we investigate whether H. pylori impact USF1 and P53 functioning. We move now in vitro, and we infected gastric epithelial cells derived from human adenocarcinoma with the oncogenic strain of H. pylori 713. Under these conditions, we observe that H. pylori downregulates the expression of USF1 and TP53 genes and concomitantly inhibit their protein level, particularly their nuclear protein levels.
Unexpectedly, we discover the presence of USF1 foci-like structures outside the nuclei in the H. pylori infected cells. As we know, the formation of USF1 P53 complexes are induced under genotoxic stress conditions.
So, to investigate the consequence of H. pylori infection on the formation of this complex, we treated cells with a DNA damaging agent, camptothecin, and analyzed in the presence and absence of H. pylori the USF1 and P53 interaction.
Using proximity ligation assay, we observe the formation of USF1 P53 complex in the nuclei only when cells are treated with camptothecins. The presence of H. pylori infections abrogates the formation of this complex.
Thus, the depletion of USF1 and its delocalization during H. pylori infection have direct consequences on the formation of USF1 P53 complexes and the induction of genetic instabilities. This represents essential events for the oncogenic properties of H. pylori infection.
To conclude, we first have shown that the expression level of USF1 and P53 is correlated with the survival of gastric cancer patient. Second, using an in vivo model, we could show that USF loss is going to favor the development of H. pylori-induced gastric cancer. And third, we could identify the underpinning mechanism that was driving this transformation. And we indeed could show that upon infection with H. pylori, then there is a translocation to the membrane of the USF1 transcription factor. This is going to impair the stabilization of P53 via USF1 transcription factor, and this is going to lead to de novo instability. Together, this participate in the transformation of normal cells to cancer cells induced by H. pylori.
Thus, our data identify USF1 as a new regulator of the DNA damage and repair response to H. pylori and a modulator of gastric carcinogenesis. Low level of USF1 allow to identify patients with high risk of gastric cancer, leading us to propose USF1 as a new biomarker for gastric cancer.